Muwada Nkunyingyi, the shadow minister of foreign affairs, fueled the matter during a press conference at parliament, expressing concerns of trapped citizens facing exploitation, financial ruin, and even war in Myanmar. He demanded swift repatriation efforts and a transparent plan to address the growing crisis.
Shadow minister of foreign affairs, I have received the credible information and numerous correspondences from victims that suggest that hundreds of Ugandan nationals, by my counting, estimated at 450 Ugandans, are being held as hostages in Myanmar by alleged labor groups for months now. Most of these victims had traveled for work, some tourism, some education, under several unclear circumstances. We don't know who took them, whether it is government or private groups.
He was joined by the Bukoma Nsimbi County Representative Godfrey Kayemba Solo. MPs faulted the government for failure to utilize the recently concluded summits of G77 plus China and NAM to negotiate for the fate of the Ugandans abroad.
Sir, that many Ugandans are being detained in foreign countries. We have many Ugandans that are being detained in Burma. Burma is near Vietnam, near Saigon. People who know that area, Ho Chi Minh City now. We have many Ugandans detained in Sudan, in Juba. We have many Ugandans detained in Egypt, and many Ugandans are detained in other Arab countries.
Continue to celebrate, and we can't hear statements that you celebrate that Uganda is hosting so many international summits when nothing Ugandan is being addressed. Because what would be Ugandan is for us to engage at international forums for the benefit and to the advantage of Ugandan nationals. But as we speak now, thousands are detained in Egypt. The Egyptian team was probably here.
Muwada repeatedly called for repatriation of the victims on the floor of parliament, where he demanded immediate action.
Right, Honorable Speaker and members, my prayers are that government of Uganda and the Minister of Foreign Affairs comes here and brief this house on the actual number of Ugandans being held in Myanmar by rebel groups, and which efforts are being initiated and taken to rescue these Ugandans. Equally, which measures are being initiated to rescue the Ugandan nationals who are currently stuck, majority detained in Egypt and in other countries of the Middle East.
In this regard, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Taye, was summoned the Minister for Foreign Affairs to appear before Parliament next week and explain the fate of the said Ugandans.
Our statement regarding this matter is a very, very critical matter which needs urgency. So Tuesday next week.
In December, the National Coordination Office in charge of trafficking in persons in the Ministry of Internal Affairs of Uganda revealed that at least 22 Ugandans are currently held captive in Myanmar, formerly known as Burma, under unclear circumstances. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.